Hello, I'm John Iskander, and welcome to Beyond the Data. I'm here today with Marion McDonald. Marion, at today's Public Health Grand Round session, we heard about the successful efforts using immunization to combat health disparities. Mm-hmm. What are some of the lessons that we can learn from that about infectious disease control more broadly?
Well, I think, first of all, we need to acknowledge that they are extraordinary successes that we've had in reducing and even essentially eliminating infectious disease disparities in vaccine-preventable diseases. I think one thing that it shows is that we can, in fact, tackle a health disparity, an infectious disease disparity, when there's a will and a way. And the way, of course, was the Vaccines for Children program. It also shows us that we need to have the programs and policies in place that will help address whatever infectious disease disparity issue we're looking at. And also, we really need to be tracking and monitoring and measuring our progress. And I think today's example was one where all of the above took place. So
yeah, very, very important points. I think much of our audience is aware that we're fortunate now to have high levels of vaccine coverage and historically low levels of vaccine-preventable diseases generally in the United States. But what is the situation globally with immunization and vaccine-preventable diseases? How is the world doing?
Great question. Well, the good news is that there has been progress. For example, in measles mortality, we've seen some reduction there. But there still are a lot of inequities, disparities within countries and between countries. And even with some of the newer mechanisms to finance, there are countries that are still struggling with the financial barriers to immunization. So we've got a way to go still.
Okay. So thinking about a physician, another kind, a nurse, a public mm-hmm. Health provider, working with a minority or an underserved population, what are the practical things that they can do in their clinic to assure that all people have equal access to vaccines?
Well, there are a lot of things that can be barriers to access, but I think if the frontline people, the clinical providers, public health people, have knowledge of what are the disease, disease outbreaks, disease patterns in the community, know what are the risk factors with the populations in their community, and also what are some of the cultural and linguistic requirements for effectively working with those populations. I think also looking at ways that the immunization visit can be really sort of an in and out and streamlined clinical encounter and kind of pare down extra steps in that process. I think that those things will definitely help.
Very excellent and practical guidance, Marion. Please join us next month for Beyond the Data.